Hey everyone, this is Ben from Boss Construction, your South Florida permitting and code compliance specialist. I'm over here in beautiful Key Biscayne with Manny Gomez. He's an amazing top producer over here in the Caldwell Banker office. So how long have you been an agent for, and what's your background?
Well, my background is exporting, and I was in exporting of auto parts.
Nice.
And then my family has always been in real estate because
cool.
we had commercial and residential properties
nice.
That they both developed, as well as then turned into rental.
So they've done building?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very cool.
They definitely have.
And how long have you guys been in South Florida for?
My entire life.
Really?
Yeah.
Where did you grow up?
Here in Miami.
In Miami?
Well, I was in Kendall, South Miami. I've lived everywhere pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah, now
so
currently in Brickell.
Have you had to deal with local government at all with doing any of your stuff?
Of course.
With the business tax receipts and...
City inspectors are very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Let's be politically correct.
Yeah.
Permitting is next to impossible sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, zoning as well.
Yeah.
It's hard. It's complicated.
It's you know, and again, as an agent, you know, what I, you know, just told everyone is you need to maintain the relationship with your client.
Of course.
And let there are certain things that, you know, we don't have control over.
Of course.
Like, for example, those stair railings or any signage or anything.
Exactly.
Like people, I was even talking to a commercial agent the other day, and they're like, oh yeah, we told them he could put up 5 wall signs around the building, and then they go to the city and do the zoning verification, and they can't.
Right.
So what is your advice to a lot of, you know, agents who are, you know, trying to do the right thing for their sellers?
The right thing? Well, first,
what do you do?
Don't do it on your own.
Yeah.
You always want to go to a specialist, someone who knows what they're doing, because the worst thing you can do is talk about something you don't know about.
Yeah.
And then it ends up being your biggest problem.
Yeah.
You don't want to dig a bigger hole than you already have.
Yeah.
So you want your seller to be upfront and honest with you, disclose any problems that they know about, as well as prepare for what could potentially happen.
So to be, for example, like, just like, for example, if you're out in Brickell, you want to know what times the store's open and,
right.
you know, what you can do. So just be proactive and have a plan.
Always be prepared.
Yeah.
It never hurts to be prepared.
Agents,
right?
You know, agents normally are, they don't have a schedule,
right.
they're not prepared, you know, they don't have a marketing plan.
Some.
All right.
That's on me.
Yeah. No, but how do you develop a routine? I'm just trying to give advice to agents and things like that, because you're well established in the business, and then again, there are some people who they don't have much inventory like you, or they're not working with a slew of buyers.
You have to start from morning and set pretty much a schedule. I'm a person that my entire life I was taught to schedule things. Ever since I was a little kid, my school would give us agendas.
Yeah.
So I'm a person who likes to write out every day my to-do list, everything that
you're like my wife.
Done, I guess.
She like no, and like a pro forma and a schedule and knowing exactly
and
what.
As my favorite thing is when I scratch everything off of the list. I go down the list, start scratching things off. I put it in level.
So you're very systematic.
Yes. Very.
That's cool. What do you say to those creative class, young, you know, just, you know, young working people, creative class who are looking to start into home ownership and kind of live in a cool area like this?
Well, a cool area like this as a first time home owner,
you can't get in,
is difficult in Key Biscayne.
Okay.
I mean, the property value here is $1 million+.
Okay.
So if you're starting your family, you know, economically, this is not the place to be. However, there are other parts of Miami, and the best way to start is always to start with the pre-approval process.
Okay, cool.
You know, you go to the bank, see how much they're willing to lend you. Pre-approval is different from the pre-qualification. Pre-qualification, the bank kind of gives you like a rough estimate. Hey, we could potentially maybe whatever give you.
Someone told me, like, I get these bullshit letters in the mail, but they told me you need a DU, right?
Yes.
And you want to make sure.
Which is a direct underwrite.
Direct desktop. And I know some of these guys don't want to, but again, you know, and and when I started doing real estate back when I left the city in 09, you saw all these listing agents say, get approved from my, you know, yeah. But at the end of the day, you want a good lender. You want someone who's going to shop.
You want somebody who is focused in making sure that you're going to get that loan. And then the best way to do it is already have that paperwork done prior to
that. Doesn't mean you have to close the loan.
Right.
And really, I was talking with someone else. The loan right now is really the only thing you have to shop. Title insurance is title insurance. Yeah. Your agent is the excellent agent. Level service.
And the houses will be there. Houses will be there.
And yeah.
But you want to have, what the thing is, once you find that home, you want to have everything prepared to present the offer to the seller. Yeah. When you have everything prepared, you come in as a serious buyer where the seller doesn't have the option to continue to fish for other buyers. You come in, you say, hey, I've already been approved for this amount of time.
You start with the amount.
These are the terms. Yeah. We're going to do the inspection in this much time. The buyer sees it and goes, hey, this is...
So the first thing you start with location, we're not starting with location.
No.
We're starting with how much house you can afford.
Yeah, because do you know how much the bank is going to lend you right now?
No.
I don't know how much they want to lend me either.
So I don't even think they'll lend me any money.
Okay, well then that's it. That takes everything back further.
Yeah, yeah.
But I mean, if you don't know what you're going to get approved for, you're going to shop for $600,000 when you're being approved for $200,000.
Do you recommend people, like, if they, for example, like, if they could, like, I had a client in Texas. It was in a nice area outside Dallas where I'm going this weekend, and they bought homes and did Airbnb, and they bought duplexes and threeplexes and lived in one and had, like, an investment. You know what I'm saying?
I understand.
The problem is, in South Florida, I don't see a place where I would feel comfortable sending my kids to school and living that has multifamily units.
There's older towns in Miami, for instance, the Shenandoah area and the Rhodes, that still have...
And there's that Biscayne Park, but it gets expensive.
Well, Biscayne Park is a little bit further north.
Yeah.
But, I mean, in central Miami, right across the bridge is Shenandoah and the Rhodes. Which the Rhodes is right behind Brickell, and then right actually west of Brickell, and then west of the Rhodes is Shenandoah. A lot of those homes have been zoned duplex since the beginning of time. So you see,
they're 1920, 30, 40 structures.
You see that a lot of developers now are building over there, tearing down the old homes for
building high or density.
Building now the dual townhomes is what they're doing.
I saw that in the Gables a lot or in Victoria Park. In Fort Lauderdale, you see that a lot.
I mean, you have that. Now, the multi-family home, that's a little bit different because that was something that they would have to get zoned for.
Yeah.
Miami is famous for their illegal
Look, the Miami 21, the zoning code, I get called all the time.
Yeah.
And there's always a third and fourth and fifth unit when it's zoned for two.
I mean, there are plenty of garages that have been converted into rental.
Those 300 square foot garages with the kitchenette, they could rent for $800, $900 a month.
If they got it with permits.
Yeah.
But the thing is, a lot of people don't go that route.
Yeah.
Which is unfortunate because then it affects us.
Well, and also they don't go that route. It's like if I was applying to an HOA and I was a criminal and I had eviction, so I moved I needed to move someone in who had a background.
Right.
I'm not even going to attempt to get them approved because they can't get approved.
Right.
There's like non-conforming uses where it's like, I'm not going to disrupt this. When I have to sell the place, I'm going to knock it down. But a lot of times, one of my friends, you know, Steve has a listing, and the family was selling the unit, and the third and fourth tenant started. They got in a fight over rent and month to month, and then they brought the city over to the property when they were unsafe.
Right.
Struck, you know, they wanted to make an issue for the landlord. So you always have to watch out for those things.
You have to watch out for everything, especially if it's done incorrectly and not done according to code or permits.
How do my viewers on Facebook and my people, how do they follow you? Like, you have Instagram?
I have an Instagram.
Yeah.
My Instagram is Mr. Manny Miami.
Cool.
At Mr. Manny Miami.
And if you want to see any other amazing videos of business people who are local in the area, real estate, outside real estate, please like our page, Boss Construction Group. But thank you so much for...
It was a pleasure.
...for having us.
Thank you.